the news started spreading out around 10th, 11th, maybe, that, you know, there's going to be a lockdown implemented. And we actually had a very big college festival. Like, it's one of the biggest festivals that we have in our college. And the funny thing that happened was people actually started speculating, is it safe or not? So the festival went down quite a bit of...
had applied to a lot of agencies, ad agencies, but all of them, like most of them, didn't reply to me. And the ones that did, they were offering me unpaid internships, and they were like, this is the new normal, and I really want to give you at least something, but I sadly cannot.
The initial phase was very unsure because we didn't know much about virus. We were quarantined in our home. We were thinking ki yaar khane se jata hai ki how to do normal things.
I had my interview scheduled for I think 23rd March or so, and then like initially they said the interviews have been postponed till after 31st March, because like that was when the first lockdown was going to end. And then later obviously I knew there was no point calling them in April, and eventually when I got a call from them in June, they said that they're not looking to hire now. So like it was a very big company. I was really looking forward to working there, but like that didn't happen.
Now, as coronavirus cases surge in India, states have upped their efforts to fight the deadly virus. Section 144 has been imposed at beaches in Odisha's Puri and Konark. Maharashtra currently is the state with the highest number of cases at 39. After Siddhi Vinayak Temple, Maharashtra's Shirdi Temple will also be shut from 3 p.m. today until further notice.
कोरोना पर केंद्र सरकार का बड़ा फैसला, स्वास्थ्य मंत्रालय ने सभी राज्यों से स्कूल, कॉलेज और स्विमिंग पूल 31 मार्च तक बंद करने को कहा।
One country certainly feeling some strain is India. The Chief Minister of Delhi is saying the city could have more than 500,000 cases by the end of July, and he says if that happens, there's no guarantee its hospitals will cope. We also got more detail on Mumbai today. Its total of COVID-19 cases has surpassed Wuhan in China, which is where the virus was first reported. And as a country, India continues to have one of the highest infection rates, new infection rates in the world.
Let me welcome you all. Thank you for being part of this video discussion, being part of Stories You Should Know's class of 2020. This has been quite a roller coaster year, and we all know that. So today I'm actually welcoming Priyal Shah, who a student of BMM Advertising from UPG. I have Bhisha, who's again from UPG and was student of BMM Journalism. I have Omkar Thakkar, again from UPG, BA Film, Television, News Media Production student. And then there is Gaurang, who is a student of BSc in Hospitality and Hotel Administration from the Institute of Hotel Management, Mumbai. Welcome, everyone. Thank you for giving me your precious time. And as you all know, we are here to discuss the year 2020 and how it's have been for the students. It has been different for everyone, and I think everyone has been impacted by it. And everyone, I have been seeing so many messages being put out for the class of 2020, and everyone's just saying to hold on and to be brave, and you know, everything's gonna be okay. But I wanna understand your side of a story now. How were things right before the pandemic hit and you know, the lockdown happened? What were you guys were thinking? How the things were happening around you, because you must have started having those plannings done. March is the time of the year when everyone starts planning. Okay, in April and May, we're going to have our final exams, then we're going to put in applications, we're going to move to another city, job, internships and everything. So how was the starting? What were you doing in March and right after when the lockdown happened? We'll start with Omkar.
Okay. So thank you so much, first of all, for having me here. And in March, I was shooting my final year film, So in this course, we have to submit a diploma film in the final year. So for 5 semesters, you study theory, script writing, cinematography, direction, all of those. And in the 6th sem, you have to apply all those things and you have to make a movie. So before this lockdown happened, I was working in casting department in the industry. And as a student, I was shooting my movie. I worked in casting department for that too. And after that, like after 15 days on 17th March, we got to know that lockdown is being announced. And all my mother and father got panicked. Bhai, tu kaam nahi karega abhi se, and stop everything you are doing right now. Come home because local trains are being shut. So from 17th March, all my plans, all my study plans, all everything is being on hold.
And initially you must have thought that, okay, it's lockdown for like 20-21 days and we're going to get through it and we're going to move ahead with it. So was that also your initial thought that, okay, it's just a matter of 10-15-20 days and then I'm going to resume with my work?
No, so the initial thought of me was that this lockdown is for, like, it's to contain the virus, because in India, coronavirus has, we found like 100 or 150 cases at the time of lockdown. And I really hope that it didn't increase from that number, but it didn't hold true. After 3-4 lockdowns, we finally, the virus broke. I was kind of hoping that we wouldn't be able to we shouldn't face the situation that was in Wuhan at the time, because we were reading news articles in Wuhan that a strict lockdown has been imposed. People are not allowed to step out of their house. It was like a world war situation, only that we are not fighting a visible enemy. We are fighting an invisible virus. So it was that. I was really hoping that India doesn't go through all of that, because we kind of knew the impact that this corona lockdown is gonna have on the economy of the country, the progress of the country, and it has really slowed down our country. And this 4-6 months of lockdown, the effect that it has had will take around 3-5 years to reverse that effect. So I was kind of hoping for a bright future. It's not there as of now, but okay.
Priyal, how were things going with you initially before the lockdown happened? What were you planning on?
So we had just finished all of our submissions and college projects, and we were finally having one last month of college life to enjoy. And I had a lot of plans, trips, and we'll go out clubbing, this, that. And then the lockdown happened and all of that just went to waste. So yeah, academically, all the internal marks and everything were added to our projects and everything. But the fun part, the last part, 1 month of my college life was taken, and that was really upsetting for me.
I think that's a mutual feeling that I can see on all of your faces. That's the last 1 month of college life where you get to be college students for the last time.
We didn't get to say goodbyes to all of our friends, our teachers, our classes. It was very sad.
Right. I know. Gaurang, what about you? How were things looking right before the lockdown happened, and what happened right after that?
Yeah, so interestingly enough, just right before the lockdown, I'm guessing the lockdown started, like, the news started spreading out around 10th, 11th, maybe, that, you know, there's going to be a lockdown implemented. And we actually had a very big college, like, it's one of the... one of the biggest festivals that we have in our college. It's basically like an entire food festival, which is organized by the students itself. And so every year it's quite a huge hit among people. Like, we have people coming in from different parts of the industry, like experts who've been working in the industry for so long. It's more of a focused festival. And the funny thing that happened was people actually started speculating, is it safe or not? So the festival went down quite a bit of, it lacked a bit of the charisma that usually the festivals have. Personally, I guess, like, it just stopped. Like, so me personally, before this lockdown started, I think most of my days spent out, like, roaming around outside, meeting people, if not doing something having going to internships and stuff like that. And it just suddenly stopped. Like everything just came to a halt for good reason. Like, I mean, I can't imagine what the situation would be if like they hadn't started the lockdown initially. Like we'd be suffering a much worse fate right now, I guess. So yeah, I mean, it was just a very sudden thing that happened. Sure, that's super.
So you kind of had like your last festivity in college, though on a very small scale, because not, as you said, it kind of died down because of the rumors and speculations that were happening. But you got to have that kind of a get together with your friends and people. You kind of started the lockdown with a bang.
Yeah, definitely.
Disha, what about you?
Hi. Similar to what Gaurang said, we literally had our farewell right before the lockdown. Like that was the last time I saw my college friends. So yeah, that was the good part, that like I got to see them one last time. But the sad part was that I didn't know that it was the last time. Other than that, yes, I had planned on working right now. Like I'm preparing to pursue my post-grad next year. So I'm preparing for those entrance exams. Which, like, I'm still preparing. The entrance exams are still going to be conducted. And the only part is, like, I cannot find paid work right now. Like, I'm getting opportunities, but those don't really match my skill set, basically. So, yeah, that is how it has affected my expectations versus reality.
So, you kind of, you and Priyal had your farewell done already. That's yes. Something I think a lot of people will envy, because most of the people haven't had chance of farewell. I think Gaurang and Omkar, you guys haven't had your farewells.
No, the farewell that Priyal and Visha attended was for the whole college.
Okay.
I didn't attend those farewells. So it was there. I missed it from my end. So Gaurang, okay. Up to you.
Gaurang, what about you?
Yeah, I didn't have the luxury.
Oh damn.
We were like, I mean, I know for a fact that our juniors, so we have this thing that like the juniors plan everything, and we were going to organize this huge feast, and it never happened because like we saw them preparing for it, but we never actually got to experience it. So it was a bit of a bummer from both sides. Like we didn't get to experience it and they didn't get to do it like for us.
I can totally understand the disappointment with that thing, because we all have had our chances of giving farewells and attending farewells. So I'm really sorry that happened with you all. I really hope you guys kind of, there's some kind of compensation for it. You know, now
yeah,
moving ahead a little. So I kind of now have a picture of what you people were doing right before the pandemic happened and the lockdown happened. And now, from my initial study, like from what I've spoken to other college students, in fact, my sister is one of the person from the class of 2020 itself. She finished her college, and I can understand she's also in the same phase that no farewell, no graduation ceremony, and all those things. So from what I gathered is the initial time frame was okay. When everyone thought that, okay, it's about maybe 1 month or 2 months and we're going to survive it. And after that, you know, we'll be back to work and we'll be back to doing it. But then slowly the market started collapsing. The jobs started vanishing. Companies started cutting down on staff, on salaries. So the jobs prospect became more sleek. There was more confusion among students. There was a state of panic also, from what I know, because yes, everyone has been saying that, you know, class of 2020, you have to hold on to it and everything is going to be okay. But from your point of view, when you start seeing jobs now in market, one was the time when you were seeing it, maybe in the time of January and February, when you were hoping, okay, this is what we're going to do. This is the kind of internship we're going to do. Now, if you see it, how much difference have you seen with the companies, with the market also? What all have you noticed? Like, have you applied anywhere, not got answers? Or have you done it before and got rejected because of the falling economy? We'll start with Bisha.
So this one particular thing happened to me. I had applied to a company. I had my interview scheduled for, I think, 23rd March or so. And then, initially they said the interviews have been postponed till after 31st March, because Like that was when the first lockdown was going to end. And some like then later, obviously, I knew there was no point calling them in April. And eventually when I got a call from them in June, they said that they're not looking to hire now. So like it was a very big company. I was really looking forward to working there, but like that didn't happen. So yeah, a lot of large companies basically had the hiring freeze. A lot of smaller companies have completely, I think for a year, they're not going to hire people. And what I see among a lot of people here in Vapi is that mostly everybody, instead of looking for jobs outside, they've started working with their families in their family businesses or whatever. So yeah, I think somehow people who were earlier not very fond of what their families used to do are now suddenly embracing it because like they're not getting jobs outside, so might as well help with the family business.
Right. And Gora?
Yeah, so basically the entire industry that I plan to work on revolves around having people, like having a crowd. So yeah, I mean, we had an interview schedule just before the lockdown. Like we had like 2 months of straight up interviews about like hotels and restaurants and all the other facilities which needed people basically. And what happened is I think around 50% of them got their offer letters, and the offer letters were scratched off because the companies couldn't help but afford it, since the main motive of the industry is having people around to generate business. Like there are obviously other departments such as sales and stuff, but like all of that revolves around the criteria that there are people coming in, and that's totally stopped. So yeah, most of the things that happened very suddenly. And I think, I mean, in a sense that it brought a kind of a sense of entrepreneurship in at least my batch and the batch that followed, because you know, it's at the end of the day, it's food, and like people have started realizing that food can be made at home. Like you don't need fancy equipment. You don't need to, like I'm sure like everybody tried something or the other making at home, and like they realized, you know, the joy of cooking. So I think a lot of my colleagues started having their own small ventures and having the cloud kitchens and having small little home businesses, which maybe help them out until the time that they can actually find a stable job. So it was good in a way, but like people who were actually planning to pursue maybe a post-graduation, let's say somewhere outside the country, maybe their application stopped, and it's basically everything has been merged with the batch of 21 in regards to all your post-graduation needs. So
right. Yeah, also the hospitality and the aviation industry was the first one to get hit before anything else took the shock. So, I mean, I can understand with the hospitality students, getting their jobs on hold, because anyways, the business was shutting, and then you guys were ready to go into the industry itself. So that's kind of understandable what you're saying. Omkar, what about you? Because you are in like films and television and news media, which was initially like, which completely stopped. Like it wasn't like even working for like 1% or 2%. It just stopped. Everyone just stayed home. Then there was this problem with the daily wage workers of the industry and everything happening. So what about you? Because you said that you were working already in the casting, and that
also
just
correctly
came on
said home. By Gaurang and Bhisha, that this industry, even the industry that I work in, films and all, it completely depends upon the audience. So if there are no audience in the theater, if there are no audience in the cinema, if there is no one to consume things, then there is no one to make things. So while that it's safe to go out for some extent, cinema and shootings will be the last thing that will open up, because it will be the last in the line. Because it involves a lot of people. Shooting involves around 200 and 250 people on set. Cinema is like 350 people in one big room. So it is that this industry has been hit badly, but still it's working with a lot of restrictions, but it has been hit. The most affected ones are surely the ones who used to work on daily basis. So we all know they don't have life savings, because they can't survive on the savings that they have done it's already been 6 months and I guess their savings have already been exhausted. So they are working, they are surviving on like government schemes and donations of people or good hearted, kind, willing people helping them out on social media. But I really feel I don't know the future of this industry for a while, but for a year or two, this industry is gonna work like this on 15 to 20% of its capacity. And more like for the, we all feel bad for the class of 2020, but it's just that we got the all the spotlight, the class of 2021, class of 2022, class of 2023 will be the students who didn't even got to experience the college life only. They are just studying on Zoom. So it is going to be tough for them, more tough for them than us, because we are the ones who experienced it first, but we are not the only one. We are the just first in the line. And this pandemic has affected a year or two of education of the whole country, not just 2020 class, but the whole country. And we are going to see the effects of it for like after 10 years or 15 years, because school children are going to be working after 10, 15 years, and we are going to experience the effects then also.
Yeah. I think it's very nicely put, because while most of the country and everyone is focusing on the class of 2020 and, you know, the challenges everyone's facing, very few people are actually thinking about how the coming classes are going to cope with the current scenario, because this particular class have already seen, have done some sort of practical work on field now and then. So they know the kind of prospects and, you know, the kind of jobs that are available, because you interact so much. Now the students who are just going to pass out from school and enter college, they are just going to be at home on screen for a while, at least till the time the campus is open and everyone just goes back studying in it. Priyal, how do things look at your end? How were they looking before and now?
So actually, towards the end of my third year, I was a part of the placement cell of our college, and I had gotten into a company, almost gotten into. There was this one round left and I had really prepared for it. I thought I'm almost going to get in, and I had worked really hard in the previous three rounds, and all of that just went to waste, and everything I had planned for 2020 just shifted. And when I called them, I kept calling them and no one was answering me for months. And when they finally decided to reply to me, they said they're having a hiring freeze right now and don't know when it will be lifted. So then I was forced to search for an internship maybe. So right now I'm interning at an ad agency, but again, it's an unpaid internship because they're saying that the virus has changed things and we cannot afford to pay you right now. So I have to now do it unpaid instead of the paid job I was going to get before things went this way. So it's disappointing.
So it's just from the kind of things you guys experienced or had, it looks like that a lot of students are being forced to take unpaid internships, and and also, like you said, that a lot of people have started their own ventures. So it has kind of affected in both ways. Some have started something with it. Some have deeply, you know, got setbacks with this particular pandemic. You know, I think one of you said about the entrance exams happening, which will happen for masters. I think Bisha spoke about it, about the post-graduation exams, which are currently happening also. A lot of colleges are conducting these exams and it's happening. I want to know your perspective on the fact that you, after doing bachelor's, now moving on to master's, again studying for 2 years, because master programs are usually 2 years. Studying for 2 years and not knowing how the market is going to react to it. Is it again a risk of, you know, just investing 2 more years into another course?
For me, I would like to do master's because I'm slightly changing my field. So I studied mass media, but then I realized that it is not the field for me. So I would like to shift my career a little bit. Like, what I want to do is not drastically different from mass media, but it is still different. And like that is why I would like to pursue masters, to study about what I actually want to pursue in life. So for me, those 2 years are going to be valuable, and like they would have been valuable whether the pandemic was here or not. Just that I, like when I start my postgrad, I would have had a little more work experience. Just like that is the only difference it has made to me.
And is anyone or anyone else from you planning to do another course, another master's degree, maybe a master's degree or maybe a diploma or some other course during this time?
Yeah, so I actually like I'm on the verge of starting like a diploma course. Like it's more based on like game designing and basically virtual VFX almost. So, I mean, I found that to be like a good prospect in the current scenario. That is what we're calling Corona now. Apparently, like everybody, like in the interviews, they're just like, we cannot pay you XYZ because of the current scenario. Nobody like, it's like this unsaid word. Yeah, so, I mean, that would, I felt like that would be a good thing to catch up on since, you know, most of the work is back-end work and like there are good chances that you can get paid for it, and besides that, it keeps you engaged. Like it can keep you engaged in all of this, in even in
right. It's never bad to have that one extra degree in your hand, which kind of exactly. improves your chances of getting a better job in future, right? Okay, I want to come to a point about what people keep telling you that you guys are just fed up of listening to, because you are class of 2020. You know, there has to be something that's happening which you are just completely fed up of listening and you just want the world to shut up about it. We'll start with Omkar. Omkar, you tell me.
So currently, there is no such thing because I'm not in contact with most of my friends. We are just quarantined in our homes and we are just calling each other once a month and all. So there is no such thing that is that ki kuch karte hain. It's like that in my industry ki kuch karte hai bro. Apan ne ye pad liya hai, filmmaking pad liya hai, 3 years it has been. To kuch banate na bro, apan quarantine mein rehke, matlab aajkal to sab bana rahe, social media pe dal rahe, to kuch karte hai. And even I want to do that, but the thing is I have allotted this time to do something more interesting that is not related to this industry. So I had a hobby for cooking, so I'm cooking. I wanted to explore reading, so I'm reading in this quarantine. But the only thing that I'm fed up of listening as a BA student, filmmaking student, is bro, kuch karte.
That's a nice one. Bro, kuch karte hain. I think it's everyone's trying to deal with situations, but I get that point. So, okay, we'll move on to Priyal. Priyal, tell me. You forgot. She's like, yeah. What were you talking about?
Yeah,
we're that talking about thing, yeah, that thing that you are fed up of listening.
Fed up of listening. Yeah. So I had applied to a lot of agencies, ad agencies, but all of them, like most of them, didn't reply to me. And the ones that did, they were offering me unpaid internships, and they were like, "This is the new normal, and I really want to give you at least something, but I sadly cannot." Not. And I had long conversations with the HR, and I was trying to convince them, you know, that it's a difficult time for me as well, and I'm expected to be earning something after I'm graduated. So, you know, I was tired of hearing that we cannot afford, even though they are like multinational companies and they're present in like 100 countries, but they cannot pay an intern some 10,000, 5,000. So I was just fed up with that.
Exposure.
Yeah, exposure can't pay my bills, but what do I do?
I same thing. So I was looking to so I'd applied to a couple places which like I thought I would get into for sure, a few startups, because well, they were startups. I did not have hope from large companies, but even they were offering unpaid internships. So like at one point I had to literally tell them that I like this internship won't give me anything new to learn. So like to me, it's a proper job itself. And the one thing that I'm tired of hearing is my relatives expecting, like my relatives asking me if I have applied to places, which basically implies when am I going to start working, because like even I don't have the answer to that.
Yeah, so the fun thing I've been like hearing like ever since all this started is like, what do you have to worry about? Like, तू तो अपना खाना बना के धंधा चला लेगा. And I'm like, this is like a very common misconception people have that, you know, this industry is just like making food and giving food. But like, there are like 100 other aspects revolving around that. And like, there are, I mean, me personally, I am actually inclined towards it. But like, I know like quite a handful of people who are not, like, who didn't join the industry just because they wanted to make food or like learn about food. There are other aspects to it. And everybody just goes like, you don't have anything to worry about, basically. Like, you have a stable thing going. But like, people don't realize that there are other aspects to it as well as that. And the other point being that, you know, like, in general, like, if let's say 100 people start their home businesses of delivering food, there's not enough ground for a single person to cover to have their business is at a stable place, or like even if it's like a home business thing, like a home bakery sort of, like there's not enough clientele left. If like 100 people in the same vicinity start, there's not enough clientele left for us to do anything. So yeah, I mean, that's been saturated, and like, you know, the limited market that is available has been forced by all these restaurants who were like very huge before the lockdown started, but like now they can't obviously operate. So they're trying to do whatever they can, like trying to snatch like every little penny from the industry that's left. So that's been one thing me and personally everybody has been tired of hearing catering.
Right. And what about when it comes to your parents? Because it is one thing of finally accepting the fact that, okay, now I have to sit back for maybe an entire 1 year and think about and contemplate how I'm going to move ahead in life with my job, with my future. And there is a whole complete another aspect to this particular situation, and that is your parents, who are so worried from head to toe about their kids' future, because they also had, with especially in India, bachcho ka future is what parents imagine since the time they are born. So right now parents are also in a fix and they don't know how to move ahead with it. So how did your parents react to it, and what were their lookout, what were their suggestions, and what is currently happening between you and them? We'll start with Omkar.
So with me is the situation that I already had a job before this lockdown. So the concern for my future was there, but it was not like on their head ki yaar mera beta kya karega aage jaake. I already had plans in my mind. I was already working in the industry that I planned to work in the future. So the initial phase was very unsure because we didn't know much about virus. We were quarantined in our home. We were thinking ki yaar khane se jata hai, ki how to do normal things. So the first concern with my parents and with me was to how to do normal things like bring ration into home or bring food supplies, or what if we got health emergency, then what do we have to do then? Because all the hospitals are occupied with COVID beds, and some hospitals have been made COVID special hospitals, so they don't treat people with other disease. So the still it's going on, the initial phase of coronavirus. We don't know much about it. We don't know how long it's going to last. But the future part is that all the parents, I guess, somewhere down the line know that this world is in it together. We are in it together. The hashtag that was trending. So it's not only about me. It's not only about class of 2020. It's not only about students. It's about everyone. It's about the whole world. So when they are thinking about it, they also are concerned about the world, because their own jobs has been affected, not only my future. My father is working in railway, so railway is also affected. Railway is also confused to how to make operational all the trains that has been stopped due to lockdown. So the thing is, the world is figuring out, not only our parents. So Yeah, just that. The world has to figure out, and we are part of the world. So we eventually will contribute in figuring out the solution.
So your parents kind of were very okay with the fact that, okay, they kind of understood what's happening out in the world, and okay, this time has to be the way it is, right?
But bachche ka future hone ke liye bachcha bhi to safe hona zaruri hai na.
That's damn true. Priyal, we'll move on to you.
Yeah, so I have been very lucky. All my parents, my grandparents have been very supportive of me, and they know ki meri koi galti nahi hai isme. It's happening everywhere, and I was excelling even before the lockdown, and they have good trust in me. So they have been supporting me to try out other hobbies, or, you know, help them in their own business so I can gain some skills before I actually go down in the industry and start working like in offices. So they have been supporting me to try out new things. I've been painting, I've been cooking. They have been forcing me to learn how to drive. So ye jo bhi extra time bacha hai, jo hume family ke saath mil raha hai, they've been trying to use it for other productive things jo mujhe baad mein shayad karne ke liye time nahi milega. So we've been bonding, and we watch movies together, we call up relatives, we have, you know, video calls with the entire family. So, you know, jo emotional aspect hai wo badh gaya hai, but of course tension to hota hai parents ko. They don't tell it to me every day, but they are tensed about it, but they also have trust in me that I'll figure something out. So that has been very good for me.
I think we all have been reconnecting with family and friends, more video calls, more us time, family time. Marriages are happening over Zoom calls. People are getting together, dancing together. So I get that part. That's quite fun. Gaurang, what about you?
Yes, I mean, I'm pretty sure both of these have spoken pretty much everything there is to, you know, how a parent works. Every parent works. Like, one thing I'd like to add is, like, no, we in general as an age are like, we in general as a generation are at an age where, you know, our parents are, if not retired, but maybe like, maybe slowly thinking about it. So, you know, us not getting a job has maybe impacted them in like a slight manner that, you know, they have to maybe postpone their retirement plans for a couple of years, since, you know, I mean, they understand that we're helpless. So they're just trying to make like what's best of the situation. So, I mean, that has set them off a little bit, like, you know, like they had this vision, like, if retirement home hoga, ye wo. And I mean, obviously that all has not been possible.
Right.
Currently, but since, like, correctly spoken by Priyal, like, everybody's been bonding. So, I mean, there's obviously pros and cons to it.
Yeah. And Bisha, what about you?
So, like all other three people, even my parents haven't pressured me for, like, the financial bit. Like, they are fine. Otherwise, like, I know friends whose parents are looking at them to earn money since they are graduates now, which isn't the case, thankfully. And but they want me to keep myself occupied in some way, as, yeah, like, develop whatever new skills you want to, prepare for the entrance exams, and, yeah, learn driving, learn to cook. Like, I didn't know how to cook before the lockdown, but now I've slowly learning them. And yeah, and like, make plans for the future that you know you will follow through on. Because basically, yeah, whatever I had got thrown off the track. So now make new plans and try to fulfill them.
That's true. I think it was very knowledgeable to talk to you all, because it's another thing to see the world from how it's happening on social media and how things are happening outside. And it's very another perspective of talking to someone who's actually right now graduating or has graduated and still into that zone, what's happening. Like, it's very different for someone like me who's already in a job, and it's very different for someone like you who will now get their first jobs. So thank you so much, everyone, for coming together and doing this. I would love if you guys would want to ask me anything. I mean, if you have any questions, why not just ask away? Otherwise, I think it was a beautiful, beautiful session. Very, very interesting.
So if I have to ask you something, then can you just summarize what new insights you got from us in this interview? and what message will you give to the audience that will be watching this interview?
Wow, that's a very, very good question. I think the first thing is that this batch has kind of understood what it is like to be in the particular situation. They want to improve their set of skills and how they will move ahead with it. They are not fearful. They are not scared. They are just trying to make, to understand the situation. They are ready to sit back, be laid with the situation and maybe look for opportunities after a year or so. Most of the students have either started working on their own set of skills, started their own ventures. So that is one amazing thing. Another thing that I understood is that your families have understood your situation and they are helping you deal with it, which is very important right now because a lot of people are dealing with their own demons. Even your family members, your parents, your brothers, your sisters, everyone has their own work problems happening and you guys are kind of helping out each other. So that is there. You all have understood that what pandemic has done to the world and you are not worried about your own future. You're kind of worried about altogether about what's going to happen to the future generation as well as to the world itself. So there's no hurry. You guys are not in a hurry, which is amazing, which I don't know if we would be in that situation of being that normal or being that patient if we would have graduated at your time. I have no idea how we would have dealt with it because now we all have jobs. Yes, we are kind of in middle of a mess, maybe pay cuts or something else, but we are not at that position right now of thinking ki what to do next. So you guys have kind of taken it very gracefully. Yes, Omkar.
I have one more important question for you.
Yes, yes.
Since you have said that you already have a job.
Right.
So what do you think your company has in the future to prepare for the new normal?
Right.
Or how do you plan to prepare for the future? Because every industry has to adapt somewhat to be relevant in the future times. So what do you think your job and your company has to do?
It's actually very interesting because, so I work with a media company. We are an online news portal and I head their digital and communications. So ever since the lockdown was announced, we have been working from home, which is since March, because the industry was shut and no interviews were happening and everything shifted to Zoom interviews, which we never thought is going to be like a future of interviews. And now we are doing interviews on Zoom. So we kind of all went back home. Right now, everything is happening from home. The good part about my industry and my particular work of area is that most of our people can work from home till the time we can figure out about their safety. At least till the time jab tak ground pe interviews shuru nahi hote hain. So that is for starters. We are still home. We are not planning to open our office. Maybe for this year. I'm not quite sure. But maybe for this particular year, we might not open the office. Once we do, we'll have to figure out, how many people to call in office. Because our office, because it's a startup, the office is very compact. We cannot let 6 people, 7 people sit in the Bay Area and, keep not even like a one arm distance between them. So we have to figure out the working pattern. Maybe some people are going to work from office like 2 days a week. Some are going to be home and then we're going to make some circulations with the rotation on the shifts and everything. So maybe that's something we'll figure out. Because you are kind of in a very similar line, I know the business has been very, very badly hit. Even our revenue is hit because the industry has stopped. There is no advertisements happening with the company, no sponsorships happening. We are also having pay cuts. All of us went on pay cuts. We also had to, say goodbye to some of our older staff members, which is very heartbreaking on our end also. So we are planning to stick on with whatever we have right now in hand, not to let go of more people. We are cutting down on other expenses, which we can. Right. If some services, online services, if we are doing, if we don't need it, we're going to cut down on that more. We are already doing it so that we can, we can have our staff with us. We don't have to let them go because that's more problematic. And online media runs on people who write news and put out information. And we need to have a lot of people on board because we cannot ask the same person to work 24/7. We need to have 2-3 people in those shifts. So that's the particular thing we are doing from our side. And I hope things get better, at least by end of this year, so that we can start having some sort of revenue sources and get back our old people. That's one thing we are trying very, very hard.
That's all I had to ask. So if anyone has any questions, then...
So Tarushi, you've been working in digital media for a couple of years now.
Right.
So what different... Like anything different that you'd suggest to somebody who's looking to break into digital marketing or digital media right now? Like the usual skills that you need to know, but anything different that you need to know because of the pandemic situation?
So I'll tell you what, I never studied digital media. So by degree, I am a criminologist. I have done my master's with the Ministry of Home Affairs. And so this digital field was never my field. That means I never studied it. I didn't know the ABC of the entire thing. One thing, if I give suggestion to someone who wants to make into it, is learn everything. Like till date, I learn things. I know how, you know, how Google Analytics works. I know how to build a website, and I know a certain part of codings. All these things I've learned over the years. So the more skill set you have, if you want to break into digital media, the better for you. Because when you go to a particular company, they'll hire you on a job. They'll say, okay, you handle our social media. You handle maybe marketing or designing of this. But if they give you an extra work, right? There should never be a point of you telling them, oh, I don't know how to do it. Always, always having extra skill set is a perk. You know, do that. If you're having this time right now, learn as much as you can. And it goes for all the fields, not just digital media. It kind of goes beyond that. If you're in a like a hospitality business, if you know culinary section, you should know table manners. You should know different food divisions, the laws, the food laws and everything. It's very important to have that kind of a knowledge. When we read about something, it's better to read something which will help you in future. So that's very important. From what I have to say, you have to learn more things. From what I have learned in last three and a half years since the time I've been in this field is... I don't think so. I would have learned it in my college if I would have taken up this particular degree, because I have learned everything practically. Like my boss told me that, Tarushi, I want this to be done. So I used to like study it overnight and complete the work on the weekend and say, okay, this is done. That's one advice from my side. That's what you should learn or do.
Also, does it make sense to zero down on a niche right now? Like I did an internship with a culinary institute, and now I realize I'm really interested in culinary marketing, but at the same time I also feel that it'll limit my job opportunities, because then I interviewed with a garment manufacturing firm, and like that is the first thing they asked me, that if you read so much about culinary and food and beverages, then why are you even interviewing with a garment company? Like that's the same thing even I'm worried about. So
I think when you go in for internships, having the experience and exposure is very important. If I get an intern who says that, you know, I have worked in culinary and I have worked in garments, but I want to come on for Bollywood, right? Mm-hmm. I want to do this thing for Bollywood, someone like me might say yes, of course, come on board. Because it depends from person to person also. Right, not always you. Your internships and your hiring sometimes is not based on your resume. It's based on someone else's perception. So that is the first thing you have to understand. If you are putting your case in front of maybe an HR, and then HR is asking, okay, the same thing that Bisha that you asked. You can present it in a way that, yes, I wanted to have more experience and more exposure. And that is one reason that I did an internship in that particular field, because I wanted to know how different is that field from the one that I'm applying to right now. And extra knowledge doesn't harm. So you'll always have to put your case from my side, I don't think so. Limiting yourself and right now hitting a particular niche until unless you're absolutely sure about it. That, you know what, yes, I want to do this thing. Then you go for that niche. But if you're still confused, this is the best time to explore. You can have 10 kind of internships. You can do 10 internships and then you can understand what is best suitable for you. Rather than you know, contemplating later in life that, oh shit, I should have tried that.
Okay. Thank you.
So I think we kind of narrowed down to everything. And you guys kind of asked me really nice questions, which I was not prepared to answer. But it was kind of fun. I'll thank Priyal for it, for getting everyone together. Priyal has been my intern. So yes.
Yeah, me know.
Yeah.
Yeah, they've seen my Instagram stories and they know you.
We also know the company name, Peeping Moon.
Yeah, so I am a pretty cool boss. The day I start my own startup, I can hire you all. Let's hope.